Welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. We're going to take a look at how you can compute the variance for a set of data. And one of the most important things to distinguish when you see the formula for this is that there's actually two of them. So you'll notice that I have a formula written here and one written here. Now the reason why there are two formulas is because it all depends on what the type of data you are talking about actually represents. The first one is for if you have a population. So are you talking about all the numbers, the whole thing? Or are you talking about just a sample? Now when you get into the nuts and bolts of these two different formulas, they work pretty much the same way. You'll be taking the individual data points and subtracting off, say, the mean, and then you'll divide it by the number of data points. Now, for the population, we use the lowercase sigma, and we use the mu. When we're looking at the formula for a sample, we use S and we use X bar. Now, one last important thing, when you're looking at the sample, we divide by N minus 1. So that is different. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at how this works really quick by just taking a very small set of data, 1, 1, 2, 5, and 6. And I'm going to assume that this is all from a sample. You really do have to look at the context of the problem to figure that out, but just for now, so you can see how the formula works, we're going to go off of that assumption. The first thing I need to compute is probably this X bar. Now that comes from adding up all of your data points. So 2, 4, 9, so 15. And dividing by how many you have, that'll give us 3. So what I'm going to do is take each of my data points and subtract 3. So 1 minus 3 is a negative 2. 1 minus 3, negative 2. 2 minus 3, a negative 1. 5 minus 3, positive 2. And 6 minus 3, 3. There we go. Now, once you've gone through and you've done that for each of your points, they need to be squared. Okay, let's make another column here. So negative 2 squared is 4. Negative 2 squared is 4. Negative 1 squared is 1. 2 squared is 4. And 3 squared is 9. All right, looking good. So we've taken care of all of those data points, and now the sigma, the uppercase sigma, tells us that we need to add them all up. So 4 plus 4 is 8, plus 1 is 9, 13, 22. So the sum is 22. So now in order to find the variance, I'm going to take my sum of 22 and divide it by the number of data points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1. So 22 divided by 4. This will give me a variance of 5.5. And there you have it. Now if this was a population, the process would work out almost identical. The only difference is we would actually divide by the 5, since in the formula it just has n, rather than by the 4. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit MySecretMathTutor.com.